Hello friends, my name is Sankalp and today I am going to show you how to create interactive resumes in Tableau. So if you haven't subscribed the channel, then please subscribe the channel and let's start this video. This was the resume I created in Tableau. You can see all the interactivity here. So we will just start with the step 1, which is get an inspiration for your template. So for that, you need to go to the interactive resume gallery of Tableau Public. Here you will find many resumes by very awesome people. So here you can see all the resumes. As you can see, I have taken the inspiration for my design from this resume. And for timeline, I have taken inspiration from here. So just go through this and take the inspiration to create your own resume. Now we will move to the second step, which is create a template in Figma. For that, first go to figma.com. If you want to know more about Figma, then just click on the I button. I have already created a video on how to use Figma, so you can just watch it and use it. Now download all the photos and logos you will be required in your template and go to remove.bg website. There you can remove all the backgrounds. So as you can see, I have used Tableau logo, MySQL logo. So to remove the background, use remove background website. So first we'll start, just create frame, select desktop and give width and height as 1000. Now go to rectangle, create a random rectangle, adjust it and give the size as width as 218 and height as 1000. Now you need to color it using hex code. So the hex code I am using in this particular resume is 505390. Now go to the ellipse. Draw a random circle. In it, you have to give width as 200 and height as 200. Now I'll just see what was the coordinates. So it was 62, 22. So I'll just enter those. And your circle is rightly placed. Now we'll give it a color as FFFFFF and we'll give it a stroke. We'll add the image. So instead of this image, you can add your own image. This is just a template, so that's why I'm using this image. To give this image a better look, we'll add extra circle in the background. So this was the circle. We'll just look at the coordinates I've used. So it was 52, 12. So now again go to ellipse, create a random circle, give width as 220, height as 220, and in coordinates you need to enter 52, 12. So x is 52 and y is 12. It will be placed automatically. You need to adjust the floating order from here and change the color from here. So just give it FFFFFF and you can see your profile picture is ready. Now we'll create a rectangle here. So just draw a random rectangle, adjust it. Increase its size according to your needs. I'll just see what was its size. It was 217. So I'll just enter in X 217 and give it a color 505390. So just let me adjust it. Okay, right. Now we'll create those white strips. So for that, go to rectangle and just draw the rectangle here. Adjust its size. and give it a white color. FF. Now just copy and paste this rectangle and drag it. Here you can see Figma automatically adjusts the distance between the two rectangles. So this is very accurate and useful. Now adjust all the rectangles to get that pattern. Okay, now we are done. Now we will create all these hexagons. For that, go to the polygon, draw a random triangle. Here you need to specify the sides as 6 and rotate is 90 degree. Now adjust its width to 80 and height to 80. Drag this polygon to the corner. Then bring that polygon below the desktop so that we can see just the part of hexagon which is inside our resume. So just copy paste this and draw adjust the view. As you can see, Figma automatically gives us the suggestions of the places where we can put this hexagon. So it is very useful to use the Figma. So I'll just adjust this hexagons. Okay, now I will show you how to put these images and how to use this color gradient in this. Click on hexagon and in fill select our color. So again click on that color and adjust its opacity. So the based on the percentages you choose, the shade of the color is changed. Now if you want to add the image, just go to fill, select image, in choose image. You can choose the image of your skill that you want to show there. So if I want to show the tableau, then I'll just select the tableau. Now I will give it a border using stroke. So in similar manner, you can create all these hexagons. Now I will show you how to create those text. So for that, just click on T. You can format that text from here, like you can change its font, you can make it bold, you can change its style. Here I have used the font Rasa, so I'll just select here. You can choose whatever you want. So I'll just write the name. And if you want to change the color of this text, then you just have to select the fill and change its color. In this way, all the texts are created. It is very easy to create text, so I am not wasting much time on it. Now I will show you how I created this pointer thing. So for that, just select rectangle and draw the small rectangle here. Then click on ellipse. Draw a random ellipse and give it a width as 20 and height as 20. Okay, now we have to increase the size. So just let me adjust it. So I will select width as 30 and height as 30. Okay, now it looks proper. So I'll just adjust this circle and also give it a white color. Okay, so you can see I have created that pointer thing. In similar way, you can create all these pointer things. It's very easy to make it. Also, I have created those bar charts using the same technique. Now I will show you how I created those circles for the project section. So for that, go to rectangle, create a rectangle. So I'll just see what was the size. It was 100 by 100, so we'll just enter width as 100 and height as 100. Click on the rectangle, go to fill, select image, and in choose image you need to select like Burger King. Okay, I'll just increase its size a little bit to show all that. Okay, now click on that point and drag it to the center so that the circle will be created. Now again rechange the size, width as 100 and height as 100, and you can see the circle of that logo is created. So in similar way you can do this for the other projects also. Now I will show you how I created this line chart. So for that, select line, create a random line here, in stroke give it a white color, that is FF FF FF, and in width give it a 4. Now again go to line, create another line starting from that point, again give it white color and size as 4. Now take the circle above, copy paste it on the intersection of these lines. Now decrease the size of this circle and adjust that circle. So you can see I have created the line chart. So similarly you can complete the line chart here. I have also created this LinkedIn, Gmail and Tableau public profile logos. Remove all the logos from your template so that we can use this as a background layout in our Tableau dashboard. So I'll just remove everything. Now click on the frame 1, go down, click on export. Here you can write the name for your file. So I am using background layout as a name and export frames. So your background layout is downloaded in form of PNG format. So now we will create a timeline. For that you need to create a data set such that the start date is like 2008 to 2010, 2010 to 2014. You can select whatever date you want, but in this dashboard I want to show the year wise distribution, so that's why I have selected 1 January of each year. Now go to your Tableau, click on connect to data, Microsoft Excel, click on this timeline. So the data is imported in Tableau. Now go to sheet 1, rename this sheet as bars. Create calculated field. For the bar plot you need to name it bar and write date difference, year, start date and end date. So this function will return the difference between the years of these two dates. Now drag this to the columns and drag timeline to color. Arrange this according to their order, so that is first is college, then engineering college, company 1, 2, 3. This is customizable, you can use this according to your needs. So for the colors I am choosing the gray color for the education and our regular color 50539D. for the companies. So for the earlier companies, I am using Lightshade, and the companies which are the most current, I am using the darker shade. This is just my design choice. You can choose whatever you want to do. Okay. Click here. 50539D. Okay. Apply. Okay. Okay. Now you can see. For better look, we'll just give white borders. So for that, select border, and in it you have to select white color. Go to format, select worksheet color to none, remove the header, and in columns remove the grid lines. You need to do the formatting and cleaning, like removing the zero lines, removing the axis rulers and everything, so that your graph looks clean. Okay, so now we are all set. Now we will create the second worksheet whose name is rhombuses. So for that, we'll create new calculated field. In it you have to write rhombuses. Date part, start date, year. So this will return, like if your start date is 2008, then this function will return 2008. So we need to add plus, then date difference, year, start date and end date, divided by 2, so that rhombuses will be plotted at the middle point of the bar plot. So now drag this to the columns. Drag timeline to color. Select marks as shape. In shape, select solid rhombus. Go to edit axis, unclick include zero, remove the header, select entire view, increase the size, and you can see your rhombuses are now ready. So we will combine this both the worksheet to create the view in our dashboard. Now we will just do the formatting, just removing the grid lines, zero lines, axis rulers, everything. Also remove the background so that they can be properly overlapped over each other. Okay, now we will create a word cloud. So for word cloud, you need to create dataset like this. So if you want to show your qualities, then those qualities which are more important in you, you have to write them more times. And which are not more important, you have to write them less times. So in this way, you have to create the dataset. Now go to your Tableau. Click on new worksheet, name it word cloud. Click on new dataset, go to Microsoft Excel, word cloud. Your data is imported into Tableau. Now go to word cloud, drag qualities to the text, drag qualities to the size. Select qualities as count. Now select marks as text, and your word chart is created. Word cloud. Now you can give it our color and your word cloud is ready. So the next thing we are going to do is we'll create waffle chart to show your skills. So for that you need to create the data set like this. You have to write skills in first column. In the column sections you need to write 1 to 10 numbers because you are giving the skills into the out of 10 marks, and you need to write the score 10 times like I have done. So now go to your Tableau, create new worksheet, write waffle chart in it. Now we'll add new data set. Click on waffle. Here you can see I have imported this data set. Now drag column to the column section, convert it into the discrete and dimension. Now drag skills to the rows, select marks as a shape, that is filled rhombus. Now we will have to create a calculated field. We'll name it color. In it you have to write sum of column less than equal to sum of score. So what this calculation do is, if your score is 7, then it will give the true value till your score is 7, and if the score is 8, 9, 10, then it will give false value. So based on that you can give the color to your skills. So I'll just show you. Just drag colors to the color section and you can see, change the view to entire view, increase the size of rhombuses and change the color. So for false we will select the gray color, and for true we will select the color which we are using in this dashboard, so that is 505390. Click on apply. OK. And here you can see our waffle chart is ready. Now we'll do just formatting, removing the header, removing the background color. Removing zero lines, grid lines, axis rulers, everything. You just have to clean out your view. Adjust the sizes of the rhombuses. Edit it. You can get black color, bold, and increase the format of the skills. Hide fields for rows. And your waffle chart for skills is ready. Now we will start doing dashboard. So let's start. First we will download all of these logos and this plus sign, minus sign, your email ID into the folder. Just export it from the Figma using this export function. As you can see, I have saved all of that in this folder. Now go to dashboard, select the size as 1000 by 1000. Now select tiled, drag image to the view, choose fit image, select your dashboard, click on apply and then OK. In layout, remove the outer padding of both dashboard and the image. Just set it to 0. Now click on floating. Choose the image and drag your LinkedIn image. Here you will need to write your LinkedIn profile URL so that when you click on that LinkedIn logo, the user will be redirected to your LinkedIn profile. So I'll just show you how it's done. As I have given the link there already, Now, if I will press on this LinkedIn, I'll just click and I'll be redirected to the LinkedIn profile of me. It will take some time. As you can see, one pop-up is here. As you can see, it went to my LinkedIn profile. Now we will do similar thing for your Tableau public profile. So just drag image to the view, fit image, in choose image, select the Tableau logo, go to your Tableau public profile, copy the link of your Tableau public profile, and then add it to target URL. Click on apply and then OK. Now adjust the size of this logo and just place it at the right position. Now drag vertical to the view, adjust its size because here you are going to write your email ID. So email ID width will be more and height will be short, so adjust according to that. Then click on add the button, adjust the size of this button, click on edit button. For items shown, select the image of Gmail, and again for items hidden, select the same image. Control drag image object to this box, select fit image, choose, and select your email ID in form of image. Now I'll go to the presentation mode. Here you can see if I click on the Gmail icon, then your email ID will be shown, and if I click on it again, it will be disappeared. Now we'll add hexagons of skills here. So for that, just drag the vertical to here, add the show button, adjust this button, in edit button, for item shown, select the image of your choice. Like for this example, I am using the image of Excel. Also for item hidden, select the same object. Now click on apply and then OK. Adjust the size of this hexagon. Okay, now it's good. Now again press shift and drag image to this box. Click on fit image, choose the information in form of image. So in this image you can add your certifications or the projects you have done, anything. So in this image you have to show your information. So if you click on the icon of Excel, then that information will be shown. So do this similar to all the other skills. Just create separate image files for each skill, and then when you click on the skills, your certifications and everything will be shown. So now we'll create the timeline. So for that, first drag bar to the timeline, remove the legends, hide the title, adjust the size of this bar plot. Okay, now we'll drag rhombuses to the view, remove the legends, hide the title, and adjust the view. as we are going to use the annotations for rhombus, you need to make it sure that you are giving enough height to this worksheet. So just drag and adjust it according to their size. Now just increase the size for the annotation purpose. Just adjust this sheet. Now click here, go to annotate, point. In point, you have to write like whatever you want, your company name or your school, college, anything. For this example, I am using school. Click on OK. Just adjust the size and location of this box. Now you need to format this. So to format this, click on format. In shading, select none. In border, select the second line and give it black color. In corner, select more rounded. In line, select the broken line and second one and black color. Adjust the annotation point and a box. Right, do this for each and every peak you can see here. So for school, engineering, college, company 1, 2, 3, everything. Before that, you need to drag vertical object here. Click on add show hide button. Drag this button to the bottom of this school. Adjust it. Click on edit button. In item shown, choose the minus sign. And in item hidden, select plus sign. These signs I have created in Figma app. So now shift and drag image to this box. So you need to write the information about your school. You can add your logo, anything. This is totally customizable and up to you. What do you want to choose? Okay, so I'll show you in the presentation mode. If you click on the minus, then it will be hidden. And if you click on the plus, then information will be shown. So do this for everything, engineering, your companies and project, everything. Okay, as you can see here, I have created it for each and every aspect. So in place of school, engineering and company, you can write whatever you want. It is up to you. Now we will drag the text here to show the timeline. So for 2008, select 12 bold black. Similarly, you can do this for 2008, 10, 14, 16, 17, 20, everything. Just edit it and adjust its location. Now we will drag our waffle chart to the skills section. So just drag it here, remove its title, remove legends, add and adjust its size. We'll need to decrease the size of the rhombuses, so just decrease them slightly. Okay, now you can see it properly. Now we will add the qualities in form of word cloud. So just drag word cloud to the qualities section. Remove its title, remove its background. So just click on format, format shade, shading, sheet, worksheet, none. It is quite messy because not all the words are shown properly in the word cloud. So you need to just adjust the size. So adjust it according to your needs. Okay, now we will see what if you want to show you the project details. So in this sample resume, I have selected some projects. So I'll just drag them as an image. Choose. I'll select Burger King. In target URL, you can write the link to your project. So it can be a Google Drive link or anything that you want to show to your recruiter. So just adjust the size of this logo, drag it there. Now click on vertical and drag it into the view. If you want to give the brief introduction about your project or the brief details, so you can convert it into the form of image and you can just drag it here. So select vertical, drag it into the view, click on add or show button, add show or hide button. Change the size of this button, go to edit button, in button style select text button. When item is shown, type minimize, change its size, give it color and make it bold. When item is hidden, write no more, change its size, give it black color and make it bold. Click on apply and then OK. Adjust the size. Adjust its location. Shift select image and drag it into the view. Click on choose. Here you can write your information in the form of image. Like what softwares did you use, what work did you do, like that. So this is up to you. I'll show you in the presentation mode. So if I click on no more, then that information will be shown, and if I click on minimize, then it will be hidden. So it is better way to show more information in very less space. In hobbies, you can do whatever you want. So if you like swimming and playing, so you can just make the icons of it and drag them here. So this was the final resume that we have done. You can do it on your own and just impress your recruiter. I am planning to create such 2 to 3 more resumes so that you can select whatever you want to do and apply it in your own resume. Thank you. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Please like, subscribe and share this. And if you want your own interactive resume to be prepared by me, then I'll do at the minimum cost. So just contact me with my email ID. And thank you so much guys.